First of all, I would like to introduce you what is protective textiles. You might be knowing that different types of textile, we are wearing this cloth, okay. What is the difference between this cloth and the protective textiles? Let me take one example. If there is a rain in outside, what will you will use? You will have raincoat. It come under protective textile. So that is the difference between normal wearable and the protective textile. If we say, if it is, we define the protective textile as a collection of textile material or goods and associated stuff. Associated stuff, it may be the zipper and other things also, used in the manufacturing of special type of or variety of protective textiles that may be used in different hazardous conditions. And that conditions and that may be related to chemicals, related to nuclear biological war type of situation. It may be used in low visibility also. Now, elastic, you know that recently we have come out with a standard on that bulletproof jackets, fire hazards, etc. These are the conditions where you can use that protective textiles, especially protective textiles. I am not talking about technical textiles, but it is a part of technical textiles. Military, paramilitary and police forces are leading consumer of these types of material. But in future, it is being used especially in public places in huge quantity. Not now, but it is slowly and slowly moving that side also. So main application, if we see that in simple way, it may be used in bulletproof jackets, especially outer cover. It should be flame retardant in nature. Body protector is one of the item that is used for protective textile. You know that nowadays different areas, you have seen the riots is going on, is a general phenomenon. You have seen in Haryana also, different types of things. They are these rioters are throwing stones and some burning tires and something else on these police forces. To protect them, there is a body protector. So that body protector is also there. NBC suits, that is very common and being used in military and paramilitary forces. High altitude clothing, that is also very common things, and especially being used by paramilitary forces, that in case of paramilitary, ITBP is using that material. Fire and heat retardant textile, that is my topic which I will cover during my presentation. And various types of textile and protective textile being used in military and paramilitary forces. Now I will concentrate only flame and fire retardant textile only, so you can understand this topic properly. How does a fire develop? That is the question you can ask anybody or yourself also. It is a very simple thing, you can see. First of all, there should be initiation of fire. You just start that fire, it comes under need initiation. Secondly, there will be a fully developed fire. You can see that graph also, you will see fully developed one. And last one is decreasing fire, that is the, it will going down. That is the three things you will see whenever there is a fire accident or anything, anywhere where you just ignite anything. And you might be knowing that fire triangle also. There are three elements required for any burning thing. These are fuel, air and heat. These three things require. Fuel, heat and air. If you mix these one, you will get the fire. You have seen in the center, you will get the fire. If there is a heat, if you have hot body, okay, and it comes in contact with fuel like petrol and air is there, then it will ignite. You will get the fire. Same way, if a heat is there, warm or you can say hot air is there, and it mix with fuel, you will get the fire. So you require three elements to get the fire. So whenever we decide to develop some textile material or some chemical finish or something else to make textile material fire retardant, what we do? We require to cut one of these things. If we cut air, for example, there is heat and fuel only. We cut air, then there will be no fire. Another way we can say that if we cut heat, कोई चीज गर्म ही नहीं करेंगे, आग ही नहीं लगाएंगे तो आग लगेगी नहीं. Simple thing, okay? So we can cut that heat also. And if there is no fuel, then there is no fire. So if we whenever we decide to develop some chemical or some chemical finish, so we take care of these things. How we protect material from fire. Whenever there is a fire accident, you may see that there is a flame or there is a fire. Okay. But the most important thing is that there is a smoke also. And there that smoke produce gases and that gases may be toxic in nature. So ye jo toxicity hai gases ki, that is a very bad. Most of the deaths occur due to that gases. Because it is a toxic, one cannot even the smoke is dense, you cannot see where is the exit door. So whenever we decide to have a textile material or any such type of material, we must take in consideration that it should not produce dense smoke, okay, and one can see through on that in that smoke, so he can see where is the exit door. So that thing is required whenever we are using any textile material in the public places, especially you are sitting over here, these are the sofa. We have to see that if it burn, it creates smokes, that smoke should not be dense in nature. So that is the most important thing. Now let me explain you flame retardant accident. If we see what is the definition, a very simple definition of flame retardant textile, those textile materials that can be used to reduce the impact of fire and flame are called flame retardant. Simple thing, कोई भी material ऐसा है जो flame और fire को रोकने में काम आएगा, that will be flame retardant or fire retardant textile material. Why we use that flame retardant textile material? Because we require life saving time or life saving seconds whenever there is a fire accident. What is that life saving seconds? I can explain it by taking example. You can see over here, there are three types of fabric material I have shown. One is the synthetic rich blended fabric. Second one is cotton rich blended fabric. And third one is FR treated or FR fabric. That is flame retardant fabric. Means I have given a treatment to fabric flame retardant chemicals. So these are the three fabric. If I ignite these fabric in same time, for example, I put a flame for 10 seconds. 10 second ke liye main isko jalata hu, teenon ko ek saath jalata hu, what will you get? You will get that cotton and synthetic based material will start getting flame. Okay, it ignited, these two ignited. But you will see that the FR treated will not ignite. That I am seeing after 5 seconds. You can see over 5 seconds. It indicates that if there is a fire accident, you are getting clear cut 5 seconds to leave that place. So this is a life saving seconds. Same way if you see that after 15 seconds, you see that the flame is now reaching upper end of these two. But in the third one, it is still not burning. It indicates that you are still getting 15 seconds to leave that one. And third one, you can see that it is just started to burn that FR treated. Means 15 to 30 seconds saving second, life saving second you are now having. Okay, so 30 seconds you get, 30 seconds, it is very good time to leave any place. If you are sitting here or anywhere, if there is a fire accident, you are having that flame retardant textile material, then you can go and exit that place. There are various types of technologies used to make flame retardant textile material. I am not going in deep in that chemistry of these making that fiber, but just telling you, one is that you can say special type of fabric. We call it inherent flame retardant fiber or fabric fiber. That type of material, for example, we are having a polyester or any type of material. When we make polyester, we require a polymer because it is a polyester, yani polymer. During the polymerizations, we add some chemical, that is a flame retardant chemical, during the manufacturing process and then draw the fiber. Okay, so the material now inbuilt in the fiber itself. So that type of material is called inherent flame retardant material. And second thing is you can use a chemical also to make any material flame retardant. Chemical means you are having textile material, you make the fabric and dip into a chemical, that is flame retardant chemical, and then take it back, dry it and use it. The difference between two is that when you wash the finished one, slowly that finishing chemical will go and its flame retardancy will decrease. However, in the case of inherent flame retardant, it will remain as such. Okay, because it is inherently added in that material. So that is the difference between inherent flame retardant and chemically finished conventional fiber. If the first and foremost important test to judge any textile material are flame retardant or not, that test is called limiting oxygen index. It is a very simple test. If you go through its name itself indicates that you have to use some oxygen, a limiting oxygen index. Okay, it is a very simple. I just explain you how you can test that in yourself also. This atmosphere is there. You know that in air, how much percentage is nitrogen, how much percentage is oxygen. We roughly say that 18 to 20% is oxygen. Rest is nitrogen and other gases. That is a rough estimate if you say. If I take some fabric sample and burn it in this, for example, I am taking this shirt and I burn it, what will happen? It will start burning. Am I right? If it is not a flame retardant. So I will roughly say that this shirt limiting oxygen index is around 18 to 20 because it starts burning in the atmospheric oxygen. Okay. If it is not burning in this atmospheric oxygen, then I will say that its requirement of oxygen is more. You have to feed more oxygen to burn it. Okay. So in this way, the limiting oxygen index increases. In railways, they want that it should be 28. Means that material will not burn in normal atmosphere. Okay. You feed more oxygen because in the train is moving in fast speed, there will be more air. That's why they require 28 limiting oxygen index. Okay. So this is the test. In Indian BIS, you know that IS 13501 is the standard that is used for limiting oxygen index testing. Okay. Simple, if you see the various types of fibers, safely I have classified it. The classification is carried out mostly by me only. To just explain you, you can see the cotton, viscose, flex, polyester, acrylic, nylon and polypropylene. The flammability of that one, we call it flammable. Why? Because their limiting oxygen index is lower than 21. Safely we can say. 21, we have taken one figure. Lower than 21 means these fiber can burn anywhere. There is no problem. Normal atmospheric condition, it will start burning. These will start burning. Then come to the next slot, silk, wool, nylon 66. Their limiting oxygen index is more than 21, but lower than 28. So we can say that these fibers are slow burning in nature. Okay. And now comes to the, we can say the inherently FR fibers. These are FR viscose, its name indicates flame retardant, viscose, flame retardant polyester, mod acrylic, meta and para-aramid, PBI. You can see the limiting oxygen index of these, 28, 28, 26 to 30. In case of mod acrylic, para-aramid and meta-aramid, you can see around 29 and PBI 40 to 42. And we call it self-extinguished, means it comes under inherent flame retardant textiles. These fiber, if you burn it, for example, if you burn it for 10 seconds and remove the burning source, they will self-extinguish. There will no burning further. So that's why these are comes under inherent flame retardant categories. You know that various BIS standards, these are developed by yourself only. These are the standards generally being used for recently firefighter suits and firefighter gloves that is developed by BIS, and bullet resistance jacket is also there. Industrial workers protective clothing is also there, and these are the various types of textile material standards which are related to flame retardancy. Another is a toxicity index. I have already mentioned it based on the gases. Now we have to see that whether the gas is toxic or not. So method is there, and these are the toxic gases which is being used: carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, formaldehyde. These are the all gases. Protective clothing for industrial workwear, limited flame spread against heat and flame, and protective clothing of welder and allied industries. The common test I have given over here, heat resistance test, same. That is, we have to put the textile material 180 degree Celsius for 5 minutes in a oven. Okay, after and we have to check the dimension change in that. Flame retardant test, same, which we have to carry out in firefighter suits also. Convective heat is there, radiant heat is there, molten metal splash, contact heat and impact. This is the test. You can see IS15742, that is a workwear. These are the tests which heat resistance, ISO 17493, we have to put 180 degree Celsius for 5 minutes any textile material, and then take the dimensions, flame spread test, and convective, radiant, molten and contact heat. These are the important tests which is carried out in this material. Another test is this is for welder cloth. In the welder cloth also, two tests are additional compared to the workwear. One is the impact of spatter. The welding karta hai to spatter aata hai na, so impact of spatter and electrical resistance. Aisa nahi hona chahiye ki wo electrical wires ke saath mein kuch laga aur the current lag gaya, then we have to test that electrical resistance also. That is the NFPA test 112, that is also there, but it is not based. But whenever you are going to export some material USA based countries, then you have to do this test also, NFPA 2112. Now I am going to show you some small videos also. This is the first and foremost important test whenever we are going to test any workwear or firefighter suits or any such type of material. That is a flammability test, vertical test. What we do, we will have a sample at 90 degree and burner will be 90 degree to that sample. We burn it for 10 seconds only, and after 10 seconds we remove the that ignition source. What we have to check, that we have to check that whether there is a hole formation or not. Okay, because it is a 90 degree. If there is a hole formation, then sample failed the criteria, or that flame is propagating upper end or either both end. That we have to check that in that. And similarly, the edge ignition is also there. In edge ignition, the burner is on 30 degree only, and here also we have to check that this is the fabric sample and that is the burner. We have to flame it, ignite it for 10 seconds, and we have to see that whether it is reaches upper end or not, or either both end. That is the pass-fail criteria. You can see over here. We are measuring the flame height also. That blue is a sample. We have to ignite it for 10 seconds only. After 10 seconds, it will automatically come out. And we have to remove that fabric. You can see that there is no hole formation. It's been sample pass. Now this is another test, that is a edge ignition. That is, in that case, burner is on 30 degree. It is not a 90 degree. If that flame reaches to last end, upper end, then it becomes fail. But now it is not reached, it means the sample is passed. So this is the test, starting test for testing flammability. So I think last is that thermal mannequin. We are not having this facility over here. I just want to show you one video of that also.
Man exposed to a flash fire with temperatures rising to 1000 degrees Celsius. The sensors record the temperature rise on the surface of the mannequin, while a computer calculates the predicted percentage of second and third degree burns a person might suffer under similar conditions. Tests show that with exposure to the same flash fire, a worker dressed in cotton.
This is the cotton base, and that is the inherent flame retardant one. You can see that it is burned completely and it is not burned.
While for a worker protected by Nomex, the potential injury level could be contained to less than half, resulting in a lower degree of burn injury over a smaller body area, and thus substantially increasing his chances of survival and reducing recovery time.
I think this is all.